Anirudh, when we think of cars, we think of anti-lock braking systems, we think of airbags, we think of crash guards, we think of a whole bunch of safety features, including head-up displays. When we think of trucks, we don't think of technology. It conjures up the image of the truck driver and his assistant sleeping in the truck, open to the elements. Paint for us a picture of how the technology inside a truck, inside a commercial vehicle is changing. What's the cutting edge of technology there?
With the new trucks coming in, they are equipped for driver comfort. You know, safety is becoming paramount. They're all coming from crash-proof features. They're getting equipped with air conditioning, sleeping berths. And the general productivity that is required for the driver is being slowly getting looked after. Mm-hmm. And this is driven partially by the fact that, you know, drivers are also becoming scarce in this country. And okay, as we move forward, it is very clear that until and unless trucks starts to take center stage in terms of ergonomics, in terms of safety, it would be difficult to attract and retain drivers. So that is one of the things. The other thing in terms of technology which is being driven is by legislation. For example, anti-lock braking systems are now becoming, it's already mandatory in trucks. Similarly, moving to better engines, better emission norms. So technology is beginning to take center stage in terms of trucks. It's not been there for a long time, but I think it's slowly now beginning to catch up.
Let me bring in Mr. Vijay Sankeshwar. Mr. Sankeshwar, you founded your company in 1976 with one vehicle, and today you own the Limca record for 2,691 vehicles.
Yeah.
That's a lot of vehicles that you own. Right? We've been talking about the state of infrastructure in India, and you're a logistics player. For you, your very lifeline is the roads under you and the connectivity between countries. How do you see the government's investments in infrastructure? Where do you see it going over the next 5-10 years? Are you going to see it happen, or are we going to be back here in 5 years talking about it?
In transport industry, transformation is taking place.
It
will take almost one decade. 10 years it will take to come to a certain shape, because our government policies or the budget they have or what they are planning is for future one 10 year, that is one decade future planning, but they are not thinking about 50 years or 100 years. That is why whatever they are putting effort is going in waste. And more particularly, if you take in only some highways are doing well now, but in a lot of state highways are in a very bad shape, and even the rural transportation is also in a very bad shape. And for the truck industry, the major thing is they all in district or the more than a lakh population, they should provide proper transport hub.
How do we get the government to do what you're saying? How do we convince them?
We have to put pressure on the government that they are not giving still more importance for the truck terminals as such, mm-hmm, which is needed. Wherever the truck parking or terminals are there, they are also in a very bad shape.
But I want to come back to Mr. Kalra on this very point. The people on this dais are amongst the most powerful people in the automotive sector in India. If you can't convince the government, who can? How is this going to change? It seems that the government is a key stakeholder, and nothing is going to move in the infrastructure side without their complete buy-in, and like Mr. Sankeshwar said, a 30 to 50 year plan. Is the government sort of perversely incentivized to just think for the next 4-5 years?
Well, I think we have 4 hours like Siam, and so I think that's what we have to use very effectively,
okay,
to convince the government that going forward, if we want to continue with a double-digit growth for some more years to come, then I think we have to focus on some of these issues and get them behind us.
What do you think is going to be the key driver in adoption of technology in this sector?
As the transport industry gets more and more consolidated, gets more and more modernized, and there is money to spare for these developmental activities, I think it is automatically going to happen. Some amount of money will be set aside by the transport operators to put and invest in these technologies, which are going to reduce the cost of operation, improve the profitability.
I'm going to go to Mr. Telang once again. A slight change of subject, very timely today with fuel price decontrol. What's the decontrol going to do for the industry? What's it going to do for the commercial vehicle industry?
Yeah, I mean, I see the government's point of view that probably this cannot continue forever, and probably we'll have to get the free market forces coming into determination of the prices. Yeah, any point of time that it comes, probably there is going to be some flutter, and we have seen this always in the past, that initially there's always a bigger reaction. Mm-hmm. But afterwards it settles down and people get used to it. And as long as the fundamentals are strong, and the requirement of the transportation continues, people will continue buying the vehicles, people keep on using the vehicles, but there's going to be more emphasis on the manufacturers to improve the fuel efficiency of the vehicles so that people can get better mileage, better training of the drivers so they understand how to drive the vehicles.
20 years from now, what am I going to be filling in my Tata Ace and what am I going to be filling in my Manza? Am I going to be filling petrol, CNG, hydrogen, or something else that I haven't thought of yet? Electricity?
Petrol and diesel is going to disappear. I still believe it will still remain a prime force.
Okay.
And even in countries like Western Europe, probably 80% of the vehicles still would be using the fossil fuels. And India probably won't be very much different. Mm-hmm. But we have a clear advantage that we have a lot of natural gas. And that being the case, the government is going to support the usage of natural gas. And we think that's a good move forward. So far as the hydrogen is concerned, again, there's a problem. That hydrogen in its pure form, to use as directly IC engines, is not very efficient. Hydrogen storage is explosive, and it's not fuel efficient either. And secondly, hydrogen production itself is an expensive process. Of course, we are trying to see the possibility of HyTHIN, as it's called, that 7 to 8% hydrogen and balance CNG. Coming to the electric vehicles, again, I don't personally think it's a good solution for the country because firstly, we are not producing clean energy.
We have a huge power deficit to start with, so
absolutely.
I don't know how we're going to address that.
25 million households don't have power.
We can't be powering our cars.
Supposing even if you overcome that, because you're talking about 2020, let's hope.
Okay.
And probably the power sector.
Hopefully the Indo-US nuclear deal yields actual power benefits by then.
Even if you have it, you still have a problem because if you're using the electrical energy and that's being produced out of coal, you're still using the fossil fuels, your carbon.
To generate the electricity in the first place.
So that's not a big advantage. And finally, you need a lot of infrastructure for plug-in of the vehicles, generating the power, and it should be able to recharge properly. And finally, the size of the batteries which are required for this. Lithium-ion batteries are very expensive at the moment, and one doesn't know whether the cost will come down in time. I would personally believe that probably hybrids for the city applications have a better future, and probably first it will start more with the buses, city buses, and probably then it will start percolating to the other vehicles.
On this note, it's time to end this panel discussion, Driven by Technology. On behalf of CNBC TV 8 in Seattle, I thank all of you for being a good audience. Thank you.
From shining malls to multiplexes, refreshing food courts to jewelry and retail, one name is now the most enduring part of our lives. SRS Group. One name, many features.
कमाल के शौकीन हैं हमारे नवाब साहब. अखबार पढ़ेंगे तो इस्त्री करवाकर छोटी छोटी खुशियां बड़े बड़े डब्बों में मंगवाते हैं. अच्छा, एक और शौक है इनका. तो क्या था वो? पान विलास, पान मसाला, जो है मैक का फ्री. कोई शौक बड़ी चीज है.
Discover the world in high definition. Tata Sky, now in HD. Watch FIFA World Cup at Wimbledon in high definition.
जब जीवन सांसारिक सुखों से संपर्क तोड़ लेता है,
मुझे मोक्ष चाहिए,
तब शांति की खोज में कोई निकल पड़ता है काशी यात्रा पर, तो कोई निकल पड़ता है हिमालय यात्रा पर.
सब माया है.
हाँ भाई, माया ही तो है जिससे लाइफ ख्वाहिशों और ख्वाबों से सजी है.
फरारी,
खुद का बंगला,
और जिन्होंने जिंदगी सपनों को पूरा करने के लिए जी है, वो जाते हैं मन यात्रा पर. तरक्की की एक नई यात्रा जहां सारा देश जानेगा कि कैसे बचा और बढ़ा सकते हैं पैसे.
पीएमए वेल्थ क्रिएटर्स प्रेजेंट सीएनबीसी आवाज मनी यात्रा.
प्रेजेंटेड बाय बीएमए वेल्थ क्रिएटर्स. रेडियो पार्टनर 94.3 माय एफएम. प्रिंट पार्टनर दिव्या भास्कर.
बस आती है.
करेक्ट.
ट्रक आता है.
ऑल्सो करेक्ट.
स्कूटर आती है.
आता है.
क्या होता है, क्या होती है, कैसे सीखूंगी मैं हिंदी.
फाइनली मेरा मतलब है आखिरकार स्टोरी बोर्ड अब हिंदी में सिर्फ सीएनबीसी आवाज पर.
और आप चिंता मत कीजिएगा, अनुराधा हिंदी सीख ही जाएगी.
स्टोरी बोर्ड के प्रायोजक हैं मारुति सुजुकी ऑल्टो.
मेरा नाम जितेंद्र खत्री है और मैं सूरत से हूँ। मुझे ये शेयर बाजार का पिछले 5 साल से अनुभव है। जो शेयर बाजार का अनुभव है वो अपने व्यूअर्स के साथ में शेयर करना चाहता हूँ।
मेरा नाम रशेश भट्ट है, मैं पिछले 12 साल से इस मार्केट में ट्रेड कर रहा हूँ। इंट्राडे लेवल में किस तरह से कमा सकते हैं यही बताना चाहता हूँ।
मेरा नाम राजेश मनसुखलाल खड़ावाल है, मुझे एक खतरों के खिलाड़ी कॉन्सेप्ट अच्छा लगा।
आई एम मोहित गवाल है, 5 साल से शेयर मार्केट में हूँ। इस दौरान शेयर मार्केट के बहुत सारे चढ़ उतार देखे है।
प्रायोजक है हेम सिक्योरिटीज और द ऑल न्यू विस्टा।
पैसे कमाने से भी ज्यादा मुश्किल है ये समझना कि उसे मैनेज कैसे करें।
म्यूचुअल फंड हो या फिर इंश्योरेंस, क्रेडिट कार्ड हो या फिर
आपके पैसे को सेव, इन्वेस्ट से लेकर खर्च करने में हमारे एक्सपर्ट करेंगे आपकी मदद।
म्यूचुअल फंड एक ऑप्शन है उन इन्वेस्टर्स के लिए जो मार्केट में इन्वेस्ट करना चाहते हैं।
समय से पहले अगर आप लोन का भुगतान करें तो नॉर्मली एक मेंटेनेंस चार्ज होता है।
योर मनी सिर्फ CNBC आवाज पर।